PreSonus just released Studio One 5.5, and today we're looking at some of the new production features in this update. So this update was mostly geared towards the project page, which is what PreSonus calls their mastering suite. I'm not a mastering engineer, so if you want to see those features, then I highly encourage you to check out some of the videos that PreSonus uploaded to their YouTube account. In this update, however, we did get what I consider to be 5 new production features, which is what we'll be covering today. Now, I almost didn't make this video because if I'm being totally honest with you, this update was a bit of a letdown and maybe even a heartbreak. Nonetheless, I thought it would be useful to at least share my opinion and start a conversation. Before we get started though, don't forget to download my free production loop kit. This kit contains 5 original loops with their stems and all major and minor triad chords in MIDI form. The pack is totally free and you can get it by clicking the first link in the description. But without further ado, let's jump right in. Okay, so the first feature that had me really excited was the chord stack. If you watched the promo video, they marketed this feature as something that can create chords for you by first creating one root note and then dragging upwards on the piano roll to create the remaining notes of the chord. At face value, this sounds completely amazing because this opens up a whole world of creation for a lot of people. All you would have to do is select the scale, lock it into the piano roll, select some root notes, and then drag up to create the chords. The problem, though, is that this feature doesn't actually create chords at all. I forget which update it was, but a while back ago, they gave us the ability to create notes horizontally, which could be used to create hi-hats or something of the like. On the Mac, you hold Option and then Command, and you get this little pen tool, and then you can just simply drag it across just like that. This new chord stack feature is essentially this, but vertically. If I select the scale, so let's do for example C major since it's already here, and then I lock it in by checking this scale box here, you will see that the scale notes turn blue on the piano roll. All this feature is doing is basically pasting the notes of the scale vertically, but that doesn't necessarily create a chord. Let me show you what I mean. So to activate this feature, you're supposed to first create a note on the piano roll by double clicking, so let me just do that here. Then you're supposed to hold the Option key, at least on a Mac, and then you're supposed to get a special little pen that you could then use to drag up. That never worked for me, so what I had to do was double click on the piano roll to create my note, but then keep the mouse pressed down on the second click. From here, the note turns blue as you can see, and then from here, I can press the Option key on my Mac to get that special pen tool, and then drag up. Now, I just created 2 notes above my C, and you would expect this to be a C major chord, but it's not. It's just the first 3 notes of the C major scale, which are C, D, and E. A C major scale is C, E, and G, and this is not what we got. If I do this again, and this time just keep dragging up to create more notes, you will see that indeed all this does is just paste the notes of this scale vertically, but it doesn't actually create any chords. This is what I mean when I say heartbroken, because they really got me excited with a potentially game-changing feature, but that's not what we got. The only way to make this work the way it's supposed to is to switch the scale to either major or minor triad, but at that point, you're only really creating variations of one single chord. If you wanted to create a chord progression, you would still have to know what notes go in what scale, and then keep changing the scale in the piano roll to either a minor or major triad until you get the progression that you want. I don't know how hard this is to implement, but the solution, at least for basic major and minor triad chords, is to tell the software, the program, whatever it is, to skip one note as you're dragging up. That would actually create the chords properly. Again, this was the feature that I was the most excited about, but it just didn't deliver. The next production feature was native note strum, and this one actually worked as advertised, but I think there might've been some sort of bug. To get this to work, first select a chord on the piano roll, so just like that, and then click on either the topmost or bottommost note, depending on the direction that you want to strum. So in my case, I'm gonna take this G here, click on that, and then on a Mac, you hold down Option and Command, and then drag away. As you can see, this worked perfectly on a single chord, but the problem that I encountered appeared when I tried to do this with multiple chords at once. So here I have a chord progression, and if I select them all and then try to drag from the topmost note to strum all of them in that same direction, this is what we end up getting. So it looks like the first chord was fine, but the second and third note just were completely botched. Again, I don't know if this is a bug, it might be, but if this can be fixed, then this feature is good to go for me. The third production feature in this update was the MIDI chord extraction. Now this one was fairly simple in that we can now drag MIDI notes and chords into the chord track which allows for the chord track to detect the chords from the MIDI and present us with their names. Now, this one had me a bit confused because I couldn't understand why I would want to drag my MIDI into the chord track when I can simply drag it into my timeline into a VST track and be ready to go. If I drag it into my timeline first, then from here I can right click, go over to instrument parts, and then extract a chord track to get the names of those chords. Doing it this way also means that I would already have the MIDI on a VST track of my choosing ready to be used. Now you might say, well, this way we get a bi-directional workflow. So not only can we drag the MIDI into the timeline and then up to the chord track, but now vice versa. The problem though, doing it this way with the new method where you drag to the chord track first, doesn't always capture all of the MIDI notes or chord voicings. Let me show you. So I'm gonna bring in a little chord progression here, a little MIDI chord progression, and I'm gonna drag it up to the chord track first, right? I'm gonna drag it up here, and you can see that it's four chords, E flat, B flat, C minor, and then A flat. If I take these and drag them down, then we get exactly that. But if we take a look, it's only the triad chords. Now that sounds great, but that's not exactly what the MIDI file had written on it. If I were to drag that actual MIDI file to my timeline first, you can see that the voicings were different. We have some inversions, we have some bass notes, and this is actually what that MIDI file sounded like. A lot more intricate, a lot more interesting, but that's not what the chord track gave us. Now I'm not trying to dunk on the chord track here. I actually really love that feature and it's useful for a bunch of different things, but it does have some limitations as we can see. So yeah, I'm not quite sure when I would use this new method, but maybe you have a use for it. And if so, then I definitely want to hear it down below in the comments. Fourth on the list, we have automation recall for mix scenes. So if you're unfamiliar with mix scenes, they're essentially a built-in Studio One feature that allows you to take a snapshot of your session and then allows you to go back in time to that snapshot at any moment. I use this feature a lot whenever I want to save my session before making a really big change. That way I can always go back if I need to. This feature is also really useful if you work with clients because that way you can save different versions of a session based on the changes that they request. Up to now, we could recall pretty much everything except for automation, but that has changed in Studio One 5.5. So to demonstrate this, let me go ahead and show you. I'm gonna go over to my mixer and then I'm gonna click on this little button right here, show scenes, and then I'm going to create a new mix scene. So we're just gonna call this one test and then save that as a snapshot. From here, I'm gonna click on this scalar track and I'm gonna right click on the volume fader and hit edit automation volume. So that way we get the volume automation lane. Finally, I'm gonna just create some automation. So let me just do this right here. So it just kind of ramps up in volume. And then from here, I'm gonna go back to my mixer window and create a new snapshot called test. If I want to go back to my original snapshot that did not have the volume automation, all I got to do is open up this window and double click on that first one. And as you can see, that goes away. The last standout feature on this update is the advanced remote control for the atoms. And simply put, this is basically allows you to control the start and end of a sample in Impact and Sample One using the Atom and Atom SQ encoders. Now those were the major production updates, I would say, but we also got two new small workflow features, and that includes the ability to time stretch an event, not only from the end like we could do before, but now also from the beginning. And finally, we also got a new snap feature here called snap to event end. The new snap feature is supposed to allow you to snap an event to the end of another event, even if that event isn't exactly on the grid. Now, I actually couldn't figure this one out myself because at least to me, it seems like we could already do this with the snap to events feature here. But again, maybe you have different results. And if that's the case, then definitely let me know down below. But there you have it. Those were the new production features in Studio One 5.5. As mentioned in the beginning, this update was a bit of a letdown for me, but I want to hear from you and what you think about this update. So definitely leave your comments down below. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to download my free production loop kit, link down below in the description, but I'll see you on the next one.